Now comes question number 42. See here, the question is, calculate the empirical and molecular formula of a compound containing 76.6% of carbon, 6.38% of hydrogen, and the rest is oxygen. Here, their vapor density is 47. That is given in this question itself. Okay. See now. So whenever we are having this calculate the empirical and the molecular formula, by the time it's very easier for you if you formulate in tabular column. Okay. So now here first we have to write the elements. So here in the question we have to calculate both the empirical and then molecular formula. So now carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So their percentage we have to write individually. And after that, atomic mass. So the carbon here, one carbon, so it is 12. Now hydrogen 1, so that is 1. So oxygen is 16. So these are all the atomic mass. So always try to write the elements in the first column, then you go for the percentage, then atomic mass, and then fourth column, relative number of atoms. We all know how to calculate the relative number of atoms. So simply the percentage divided by the atomic mass. So that will give you the relative number of atoms. So individually we have to calculate for carbon, hydrogen, and then oxygen. So after that we have to convert it to simplest ratio to get the empirical formula. So here approximately we have to take, okay, if it comes in decimal, we have to convert it to approximate manner. So here 6.3, so it is simply equal to 6. Okay, see here, the 6.38, that is divided by this one. We have to choose the least number. See, among this three, this one will be the least number. So divide all those value with the least number, so that we'll get the simplest ratio. So when we divide it with this simplest, sorry, least value, we get 6, and here also 6, and then 1. Okay, so approximately we have to write. So now the simplest whole number ratio is 6, and here also 6 for hydrogen and 1 for oxygen. So after the simplest ratio, we have to write the empirical formula. So the empirical formula, carbon 6, hydrogen 6, and then oxygen 1, that we have to form. So now we have calculated the empirical formula. Okay, so now we have to calculate for the molecular formula. So we all know how to calculate the molecular formula. So the molecular formula will be calculated by N will be equal to molecular mass divided by empirical formula mass, or calculated empirical formula mass. So that will give you the molecular formula. So the molecular formula is the whole number ratio. So now in the question they have given the vapor density, right? See here, this vapor density is nothing but it is simply a density of a particular gas or vapor. Density of a particular vapor or gas, that is said to be a vapor density, and that leads to the same temperature and pressure. Okay, so now we all know what is meant by density. So density is simply mass per unit volume, and this vapor density means the density of a particular gas or vapor that is relative to the hydrogen at the same temperature and pressure. That is said to be a vapor density. Okay, see now the molecular mass is given by 2 into vapor density. Okay, so this is the formula. So now, see here in the question itself, they given the vapor density value, so that we get the answer 94. So now the molecular formula is simply empirical formula into N. So now N will be equal to molecular mass divided by this calculated empirical formula. See here, C6H6O. So carbon is 12. So that 12 into 6. And now next comes hydrogen. So hydrogen 1 into 6. Again for oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen, so simply 16 for 1 oxygen, right? So totally we get the answer total as 94. So that will be the empirical formula, that is 94. See, now the molecular mass is simply 94, that is divided by the calculated empirical formula 94. Okay, so that we get, when we divide we get the answer 1. So which means now we can tell the molecular formula is C6H6O, same as the empirical formula, both are same. Suppose if we get any number 2, 3 like that, then we have to multiply this constituent atom with that 2 or 3, that will give you the molecular formula. Here we get n will be equal to 1, so it will be quite easier for you. So simply you have to multiply it with 1, right? So now we have calculated all the empirical formula as well as the molecular formula for this question. Okay, see, now we move on to question number 43. See, here in this question, a compound on analysis, it gave, here the value they have given is that for sodium it is 14.31% and for sulfur it is 9.97%, hydrogen 6.22%, oxygen 69.5. So here in the question they asked to calculate the molecular formula of a compound, and here sometimes the question will be given in twisted form. See, here they are given a new term, that is if all the hydrogen in the compound present in combination with oxygen as water of crystallization. So this is simply the water formation, and now the molecular mass of the compound is given. Okay, see, now we'll go for the solution. See, here also we have to tabulate the given data. See, here the element is sodium, sulfur, hydrogen and oxygen. Whenever the question given, simply you have to go for the tabular column and you have to write a specified data, that is, so here the data for sodium, the percentage given is the respective value, and now the atomic mass, sodium will have the atomic mass of 23, sulfur 32, hydrogen 1 and oxygen 16, this you know well. See, now we have to calculate the relative number of atoms. See, the relative number of atoms is calculated by the same as we discussed in the previous problem, the percentage divided by the atomic mass. So that will give you the relative number of atoms. See, after this, we have to convert it into the simplest ratio of atoms. So that will be obtained by dividing it with the least value. Here, we all know which will be the least value. 0.3 is the least value. So if we divide it with the least value, the first we get 2 and here 1 and here 20 and here 14. Okay, what are the value we get, that we have to write. Okay, simply we have to approximate and write. And after that, here you see the simplest whole number ratio 2, 1, 20 and then 14. Okay, see, now in the question they have given on word, all the hydrogen in a compound is present in combination with oxygen as water of crystallization. So now all the hydrogen combines with the 10 oxygen. So see, here we have to write the, see, now the hydrogen and then oxygen, and here the hint is that water of crystallization. So it is simply a water formation. So now we have to check for the oxygen and then hydrogen. See, now in this question, right? See, now we can write Na2 because here 2, and now the sulfur is 1 mole and hydrogen 20, oxygen 14. Okay, so this is how we get. See, now we have to check with the hint that is given in the question. That is the water molecule. That is all the hydrogen in the compound present as water. So which means hydrogen present as water. So now we have to write. So here totally 20 hydrogen. On comparing with the oxygen, so the relevant number is that 10. Okay. So now if you multiply this 2 with 10, we get 20 hydrogen. So now it is equal to this 20. Okay. So now here I have calculated the molar mass of this calculated empirical formula. So now here the empirical formula is simply for, that is for sodium it is 23, 2 moles are there, so simply 2. And sulfur 32, here 1 sulfur, oxygen 16 into 4 plus, here you see 10, this 10 is common for this H2O. So now hydrogen is 1, here 2 hydrogen, so simply 2 plus 16, that is 1 oxygen. So 16 plus 2 is simply 18. So that only I have written here, 10 into 18. So now on adding all this, we get the answer 322. So now this 322 is the calculated empirical formula mass, and in the question itself they gave the molecular mass. So now both on division we get 1. So simply we can write Na2S O4 into 10 H2O, because in the question they gave all the hydrogen in the compound present as water of crystallization. That is, so only we have to write in this form. So this is simply sodium sulfate with 10 moles of water molecule. Okay. See, now we'll move on to the next question. Before that, always try to practice the problem that I solved. Also, you have to practice. So when you look, it will be easier for you. But once if you try to solve it, you will get a lot of confusion. So to avoid that, try to practice the problems. Okay, see, all the things given here, it will be looks very easier for you, but always try to practice, so which won't give you any confusion. Okay.